Speaker of the House Nancy Pelosi's Capitol security plans recommend adding more fencing around the Capitol building, as well as more than 1,000 Capitol police officers at a price tag of $100 million. This just months after many in the Democratic Party supported defunding police departments. And joining us now to discuss this is AM 760 radio host and KUSI contributor, your favorite and mine, Mr. Mark Larson. Mark, good to see you.
Hi, Ginger. You know, it's interesting, isn't it? Here in the same administration that now, and Pelosi's in sync with it, loves to de-emphasize security at the border, is amping it up in the nation's capital. As somebody who's gone to Washington many times, first time when I was a kid long ago, this the fact that it's become this fortress now is hard to imagine, but it is. And hey, what's a few, 100 million here, 100 million there? There's a lot of things wrapped up in this story, as you know.
Yeah, that's a great comparison because, I mean, we're seeing over 1,000 people flooding the border every day, and they aren't border barrier friendly in the Democratic Party, but yet they want to put one up around the Capitol. And interestingly enough as well, when the Portland riots were going on for how long? 3 months or so?
Well, I lost count at 119 nights or something like that, and that was just a peaceful protest that, of course, included burning things and whatever. The dichotomies are all over the place. And here's another thing. This whole deal about yesterday, March 4th, which used to be inauguration day till they changed the laws years ago and moved it to January. And there was this QAnon and all this kind of internet thing, at least in some circles, that was the real inauguration day. And somehow Donald Trump was going to assume the mantle of the presidency. Yeah, let's face it. There's all kinds of stuff that is out there on the internet. And of course, right now, if you're on the far left, apparently you don't get censored the same way you do on the right. But that said, was it necessary to say, oh, my goodness, we better change the schedule yesterday for Congress, as they did? Pelosi adjusted some meetings. Some people fled the city. You have that kind of a fortress. Who in their right mind or wrong mind is going to think this is a great day to try to storm the Capitol? So the questions are, was it credible evidence or was it just something that was out there? I realize people like Mike McCall, who is a Republican congressman out of Texas, said, well, it could be credible. I'm not sure what he was reading online, but it made no sense. And nothing happened yesterday, nor did anything happen that was at all pro-Trump anything around the country. So this becomes another way to keep power and keep this handle on Washington. 15,000 troops there, more than at the Civil War and some other junctures. And I guess in a few weeks, they'll be down to 5,000 troops. But now they're going to have troops in Washington and these barricades up for, 60 days plus the 100 million. It doesn't make sense. And here's the thing. There's always people on right or left on the fringe saying some crazy stuff. There were plenty of people saying that, and we saw it in the streets in Portland and so forth when Trump was there. Trump did not, to his credit, as much as he could be controversial, didn't do this in Washington. So what do we read into that? I'm not sure yet, but it's curious.
Where does this $100 million come from?
Well, that's coffee money back there. We're talking 1.9 trillion. That's, this is actually refreshingly small, 100 million. But again, do you need that many police or do you need a better system? What happened on January 6th? All those questions. We keep finding out more of the things that didn't happen and that it was a horrible day. Nobody says, oh, that was great, except the people who got arrested. And that wasn't, what was that? I think there's 300 arrests. I'm not excusing them, but there weren't 40,000 arrests or none of that. There was a report the other day they found no firearms. So all of this becomes never let a crisis go to waste. It's easier to kind of keep people sick and nervous about this while we're cowering with our masks and wearing two and so forth. Reminds me of back in the 90s. When Clinton was there and they had somebody trying to, as there always is, somebody trying to get into the White House from the north side by Lafayette Park. So what did they do? Back then, they closed Pennsylvania Avenue, so it became more difficult for the people to see the people's house. Now there's even bigger fences around the White House, again, more border around the White House fences, and you can't get nearly as close as you used to. That's not what the founding members of our republic thought should be the case. Yeah, security, absolutely, but at some point, what do? You just cordon off the whole city forever? It's really bizarre and preposterous and not workable.
Yeah, it's just really interesting to see one day they don't like law enforcement and the next day they want to utilize it. I'm curious, Mark, we always see you. Is that a fancy background behind you or are those real books that you really read?
These are real books. Real books.
Okay. All right. You've read
them? That's right.
You've read those books?
Most of them. It's my other brain.
All right.
Such as it is.
All right. It wouldn't be a Friday if I didn't hassle you. So thank you
for
your time.
I appreciate it. Always special.
Weekend.
All right. See you.